Hey, hey, it's your girl, Inez, Natural Fit Talker, and we are here on this beautiful morning getting ready to get our workout on. So make sure that you consult with your physician before you start any workout regimen. Today we are going to get started with just a little bit of stretching. We want to make sure that we always stretch when we get started, that our stretching is very important. So let's just get started with a deep inhale and exhale. Let's do that again. Inhale and exhale. And let's roll the shoulders back. Good. It feels so good to be alive and forward. We have the activities of our limbs. Our minds are right, and we are getting ready to do something good for our bodies. Nice and slow, take it over and hold. Wrap your hand around the ankle. Good. Let's bring it back up nice and slow. And do the same thing on the other side. Try to move over so you can see me. And bring it up. My little photographer is sleeping, so I got to do this all on my own. So let's take a nice, deep, wide stance, and let's kind of just sit back just a little bit, and let's lunge over. Good, and hold it. And let's take it over and do the same thing on the other side. Now let's just alternate. Together. Let's bring the knees up and out. Bring the knees up. Good. Let's take it around for a trunk roll all the way around. Now let's take it in the opposite direction. Right, so that's a little bit of stretching. Now we're going to go into a quick warm-up, getting the muscles working and also getting the heart rate up just a little bit, okay? And we're going to continue to warm up after this because we don't want to start out because we're doing a high-intensity interval training today where we're going to do exercises for 30 seconds on and then we're going to do an active rest for 12 seconds. So we got 30 seconds of work. 12 seconds of an active rest, which means that we're not doing a high intensity exercise, but we are still moving actively, active rest. Okay, so I'm going to start with jump rope. If you don't have a jump rope, you can do jumping jacks, you can do a running in place, you can do kicks, front kicks, just something to just get you started, okay? So like I said, I'm going to do jump ropes, all right? So let's get to work. So that was starting of our warm-up, and now we're going to keep the warm-up going. It's just marching in place. Let's march it out. Get those knees up. And tap it out here. Tap. Tap. We want to slowly get the heart rate going. Hands up. And let's twist. Twist it out. Abdominals are tight. And let's extend the arms out in front. bring it up. Back out in front. Overhead. Back in front. Single arm shoulder rolls. Arms out in front. Overhead. Single arms. And twist it out. Let's tap it out. Hands on hips. Let's bring the hamstrings up. Let's bring the arms with us, pull back. Knees up. Back to hamstrings here. Knees up. The height of you bring your knee up, it's not a big deal. If you have knee issues, if you're here, that's better than nothing at all. If you can't bring your knees up at all, just stay tapping. Okay? Here you go, knees. Now we're just gonna hold it on one side with our knees, okay? Here we go, here. Stay here. Let's take it to the other side. Now march it out. March it out wide. Bring it back in. All right, so now let's talk about this workout we're getting ready. That was a warm-up. So you keep moving while I'm talking. Just keep moving. As I stated earlier, our workout, we're doing 30 seconds on, and then we're gonna do 12 seconds of active rest where we're gonna move. Our active rest exercise will be punches, okay? With your punch, you're gonna take a slight bend in the knee, make sure your feet are shoulder width apart, in line with your shoulders, and you're gonna, I'm gonna turn to the side so you can see. You're gonna take a nice little sit here. See how I'm doing? You don't have to come all the way down, but right about here, and you're gonna punch. I don't wanna see this. You're not doing cross punches, you're just jabbing. That's your active rest, okay? All right, so our exercises today, we have butt kickers, skiers, skaters, squat jumps, high knees, bicycles, V-sit punches, leg raises, and cross climbers. And then we're gonna stretch, okay? I'm gonna demonstrate one round, but you all are gonna do three rounds, which means you're gonna repeat this two times after my demonstration, okay? So be honest with yourself, push yourself through. If you gotta stop and pause it, count down, get a break, get some water, do what you need to do, but you can make it through. If it don't burn, it doesn't make sense to even do it. It must burn. Work past the burn to get results. If you only work three or four past the burn, that's more than what you did the last time. You are only in competition with who? You, yourself. All right, so let's get this show on the road. Let me get my timer going, and then we'll get. All right, we're doing butt kickers. Abdominals tight. First exercise, butt kickers. And modification is here. Okay, you can bring it up, bring it up. Active rest. You don't have to go as fast as I'm going. You can slow it down or take it faster. Whatever level you're at, next exercise, you're doing our skiers. If this coffee's not going to work for you, just step over. Like this. Like this. Or you can hop. Push past the burn. Push past it before you take a break. And push past it, you can't do it anymore. Here we go. Next, we're doing skaters. Make sure you're breathing. Let's skate. Now, this is low. And hop it over. Remember, you're only competing with yourself. It's lunch. Next exercise, squat jumps. This is your squat jump here. Or just do a squat. Make sure you're squeezing on the way up though. Squeeze the glutes. Or you come up on your toes. All those variations work, okay? I'm gonna do a few of them. I'm gonna jump, then I'm gonna show you how to do on your toes. Now I'm gonna show you a regular. Just squat. Okay, let's punch. Next exercise, high knees. This is your high knees here. If this does not work for you, come here. Push. Push, push, push. Push. You got it. 3, 2, 1. Let's punch. Next, we're getting down on the mat for bicycles. Mat, bicycles. Turn to the side for you. This is not work for you. Just do regular sit-ups or punches. Just keep moving. Just punch. Back down on the mat. And this is what we're going to lean back and punch. Contract the abdominals. Punch. 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 You got it. Punch. 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 Let's go. Punch. Punch. Push through it. I feel my abdominals. All right. Woo. That was no joke. Let's punch. Next, we're going to leg raises on the mat. Okay, this is your leg raise here. You lift it up. If you can put your hand underneath your glutes for support, that is fine. Push through it. Let your feet touch the ground, the floor. I have to turn this way, y'all. Oops, well. I was turning that way because I was slipping off the mat and didn't want to touch the ground. Okay, cross climbers. This is the cross climber. So you take your knee to elbow. One across the back. Make sure your bottom is not up high. Last exercise, we're going to do plank jacks. This is your plank jack. That's high, this is low. Punch, last punch, and then you start everything over again. All right, so that was round one. So you're gonna do two more rounds of this, okay? So next, once you finish with your next two rounds, you're gonna do the stretching that comes next, okay? The cool down and stretching. So we finished those three rounds. Now we're going to get into our cool down stretching, all right? Because you did abs within the workout. So I put those in there when you were doing the bicycles and the other four exercises. Okay, so let's talk a little bit about stretching. Stretching improves your performance with physical activities. It decreases your risk of injuries. It helps your joints to move through their full range of motion. It increases muscle flow, enables your muscles to work more efficiently, and improves your overall daily activities. And as older adults, when people are older, like our grandparents and our parents, they need to stretch because they want to reduce low back pain and arthritis. And the causes of lower back pain in older adults is commonly a result of osteoarthritis. Also, stretching for older adults help improve poor posture. You kind of see some older people, they're kind of humped over. Even now, I pay attention to how my shoulders might roll forward and I pull them back up. So you want to make sure that they are stretching so that their posture is improved. And stretching increases blood flow and energy levels. Okay, so that's what we're getting ready to do now. So let's just stay here on the floor from you doing your last round. So we're gonna lie back. Move my camera so that y'all can really see me. I'm going to move my camera because it's not a good angle for people to see exactly what I'm doing. Sorry about that. Because there are some people who this is new, and I want everybody to see. Okay. So here we go. Sorry about that. Overhead, deep breath in. And exhale. Deep breath in. As you exhale, bring your knee to your chest. And hold it.
Keep me safe,
extended. Sorry, not extended. Keep rotating, sorry. Now extend straight up and gently pull towards you, taking your shoulders and head off the mat. There we go. That was heavy. Mom, because I'm on an incline, first of all. Push your heels down towards your mat, alternate. Let's walk our hands to our feet.
Me up.
Bring it up nice and slow.
Hold me down.
Your shoulders back.
Take some time and stay with me.
take 3 deep breaths. Let's take it in. Remember, health is wealth, and smile because God loves you, and so do I. Have a great day.